Rise and shine, Rwanda. It's Thursday, the 14th of January.
Good morning. It's just after 7 o'clock in the morning and you're watching Rise and Shine Rwanda with me, Ivan Magwene.
And me, Yvette Shimbusho.
Over the next hour, we'll bring you all the latest news, sports and business headlines from here in Rwanda and around the world. And of course, starting with business. Yvette, what do you have for us?
We're going to be looking at the horticulture industry and more specifically, the flower industry. Mm-hmm.
All right, yes, Sherry?
Sector of it, actually.
Okay. Sherry, lifestyle?
Today's movie review and cult classic.
I'll talk about it.
Which I won't tell you guys, obviously.
I can't wait. Moses, Chan is on the way and
yes,
we have a load.
But on top of Chan, hard working pays off. Mm-hmm. And that was the evidence for our captain, Jacques Tuyisenge, to be now recruited by Gor Mahia, the champions of Kenya. Now he's become a professional like all other Rwandans. Mm. So I'll tell you more in details and how it happened and how much he was bought.
Great story over there. Well, all that and more still to come, but first, of course, is the Rise and Shine story of the day. Welcome back to Rise and Shine Story of the Day. My name's Ivan Magwene. Well, the clock is ticking as Rwanda hosts CHAN 2016. This is a great moment for the football fans out there and especially for our homeboys, the Amavubi Stars. And before we have a deep analysis with our guests today, here's a report we compiled for you. Let's take a look. Joining us in studio to talk about CHAN and of course the Amavubi Stars are two gentlemen who of course you are familiar with in Rwandan football. We have André Kasabongo, coach of Police Football Club, and Habimana Hemedi, who is in charge of the mobilization of the Amavubi fan club. Rise and Shine. Of course, nkuko tubizi nuko natangiye mbivuga CHAN iri mu nzira kwa gatandatu irushanwa riragera I Kigali turabona match ya mbere iza ariko nk'umu coach ufite abakinnyi benshi ba muri police ariko nanone bakinira equipe nationale Amavubi urabona imyiteguro igeze cyane cyane dore ko namavubi yaramaze iminsi itandukanye akina imikino ya gishuti n'amakipe atandukanye
kwizina bari mbungo ni mbungo
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 hanyuma amavubi yagaze neza no munsi na examahirwe kubona imyitozo yabo narebye match zabo ya Cameroon na Congo urabona ko bahagaze neza urebye umupira bakinye n'uburyo biteguye bibaza ko biteguye neza ku buryo bashobora kwitwara neza muri CHAN zaba kwa gatandatu hano.
Okay, nkumbizanye urundi impamvu wenda twashatse no kuba twagutumira nk'umuntu umukocu urareba ukareba mu bujyanye na technique ukareba ukanariza neza match ukareba aho hari ibibazo bitandukanye ushobora ko warabonye matches zitandukanye amavubi yagiye agira mu mikino ya gishuti iyo urebye neza ubona nihe amavubi akomeye nihe wumva hakuye kongerwa imbaraga mu magambo make uko byumva
mu rwego ruri conscious physique amavubi ahagaze neza wareba mu rwego ruri technical tactical ni bameze neza cyane ngira ngo aho bagomba kwamirana ni muri niveau psychologique c'est-à-dire ni ibintu biri psychologique mu buryo bagomba kwigira confidence kandi bakamenya ko turi mu rugo bagomba kwitwara neza ntibaterwa ubwoba n'abantu benshi bahari cyangwa n'abadversaire bazaba bafite imbere yabo bakamenya ko igihe cyose bifite icyizere bishoboka ko bagushobora kuri resulta nziza
okay icyizere nje cyambe tukuye kubaka ndakomereza kuri wowe nka umuntu ushinzwe mobilisation muri Amavubi fan club ufite akazi katoroshye muri no minsi ko kuba warimo kumobiliza abantu batandukanye ariko mbere na mbere ndashaka kumenya mu byukuri fan club imeze ite cyane cyane mu gihe cyane iri mu nzira uko bihagaze ubu ngo
ngira ngo nitwa Minani Hemedi ndagira ngo mubwire ko fan club imeze neza abafana umunsi niwe batindiye isaha niyo batindiye ako kigaragara cyo bariteguye ndetse tumaze n'igihe duhura n'abafana batandukanye bo mu bice bitandukanye bahoraga bumva cyane zabiri ahandi rimwe na rimwe n'abakinnyi bacu bajyayo birumvikana nibagira amahirwe yo kugira ngo bitware neza ariko ntekereza yuko ari experience abakinnyi bagiye bakura iyi akaba rimwe mu mpamvu rero noneho abafana bifuza kuyirebera imbona nkubone aho tugize umugisha aho kugira ngo iyo cyane ziyo iwacu mu Rwanda Habana kugira rero yuko mu bice bitandukanye abahuriga ubu ngubu mu minota mike yashize abenshi twari turi kumwe nabo kuri stade amahoro aho barimo gukurikirana imyiteguro y'ikibuga kiri gutegurwa gute aho twamaze gushyira stand yo gucururizamo imipira n'ibindi bikoresho birimo ingofero uyu munsi rero nakubwira yuko abafana barateguye ndetse turacyakomeza no kugira ngo tubategure kurushaho kubera yuko abantu bazababonana imyambaro mishya itandukanye niyo babonanaga ikindi bya bikoresho byabo bakunze gukenera harimo amarangi bisiga agaragaza ibendera ry'igihugu cyacu harimo ubushake bari basanzwe bagaragaza bizaba binyuranye cyane yewe hariho n'ibindi bintu bishya abantu bazabona twatekereje no gukitsina gore aho twumva abana b'abakobwa ndetse n'abadamu twazanye umuntu uzaba makia ku muryango aho ku matama bashobora kuzajya babashyiraho akabendera nk'uko twabibonye muri Brazil nk'uko twabibonye South Africa n'ahandi iyo umuntu akopera buryo ibyiza ntekereza ko bataruhuswa
cyane rwose ntabwo bararuhuswa cyane nanone nkihagaze ku kijyanye n'abafana uko biri kose u Rwanda ruri mu rugo abafana barimo bantu bazatuma ikipe ishobora kuba yagera kure mwebwe nka fan club ni izihe strategy mwa muri no minsi mwari murimo gukoresha kugira ngo kuri buri kibuga nibura ahantu hari gukinira ikipe y'u Rwanda tuzabona umubare udasanzwe w'abanyarwanda baje gufana cyane cyane dore ko nibiciro reba by'amatike nibura byagiye bigabanywa ni ze strategy n'ingamba mwafashe muri no minsi
urabivuze ni byiza strategy ya mbere nta yindi niyo ngiyo no gukuraho ibiciro byari bisanzwe kuko nimba APR yakinaga na Rayon Sport police yakinana na APR cyangwa na Rayon Sport amatike ahasanzwe hose bikaba 2000 Uyu munsi none umuntu akaba yabigize amafaranga 500 kandi akareba imikino ibiri no kuvuga ngo umukino umufite agaciro k'amafaranga 250 icyo bisobanuye no kugira ngo akazi kazabe gakeya ku muryango ba bantu barwaniraga gushaka kwinjira babatishyuye ko amafaranga ari menshi noneho tuyagira amafaranga angana na mituyo ntekereza ko rero nta munyarwanda uzagira impungenge zo gutanga amafaranga 500 yaba mu cyubahiro cyangwa sahasigaye hose urye byiciro by'abantu n'Imana yaradutandukanyije ariko igikenewe niko ikibuga tuzaba tureba ari kimwe n'amayikipe aramwe aba nakubwira ko rero zimwe mu ngamba zihari mobilisation yakozwe ku bibuga bitandukanye nk'abantu bazaba bari Rubavu nabanza ngashimira umuyobozi w'akarere ka Rubavu kuko mu mikino ibiri imaze kuhabera abahungu b'i Rubavu bambaye imyenda myiza abakecuru abasaza ngira ngo abakurikiranye umukino w'ejo bundi ubwo twatsindaga abakongomani barabibonye bwo kuva ku kibuga kugera ku musigiti abantu bari ku muhanda iburyo nibumoso ikibuga cyo cyaruzuye babonye ko nahandi hantu bari buge bafata icyemezo cyuko bagomba kujya kwihagararira ku muhanda bakaza gutegereza ama equipe nibura bakareba abakinnyi b'amavubi icyo rero ni kimenyetso gikwereka yuko karere ka Rubavu kakoze mobilisation nongera no kubashimira cyane kuba uyu munsi mu gitondo babyutse bakora ibintu umuntu yavuga yuko ari ugutunganya tere aho batekereza ko nk'abantu bashobora kuba bakwambura abashyitsi bacu babana b'amayibo busanga education yabigoye biriwe rero bashaka uburyo babashyira mu kigo kimwe babatoze babigishe ku buryo abashyitsi bacu nibaramukabaje nta kibazo bazahura nacyo muri Rubavu twavuga ko rero karere ka Rubavu fan club yaho baba bafana ba Marine baba bafana ba Itensel ndetse n'abayobozi ubwabo uhereye ku muyobozi wa karere kugeza ku muyobozi w'umudugudu nababwira ngo felicitation twerekeje rero mu karere ka Huye ndagira ngo ubwize ukuri yuko hari aho urumva hariyo navuga ngo na karere kajijutse kuva kera na karere kariyo universite ya mbere yabayo hano mu Rwanda abo banyeshuri rero inshingano ya mbere bafite barabizi yuko nibyo barimo bariga no kubera igihugu yicani rero usibye kureba ngo igikombe ariko genda banza ngashakisha izindi nyungu nyinshi zitari igikombe inyungu nyinshi rero zihari no kubasha kumenyekanisha u Rwanda mu ruhando mpuzamahanga no kwerekana isura nyayo y'u Rwanda kuko baraduharabitse cyane bamwe mu bafite izo nshingano rero navuga ngo nabanyeshuri bari muri kaminuza abarangije muri kaminuza bo bashobora kuganira nabari abanyamahanga mu ndimi zose bashobora kuza bakoresha bisobanuye ko rero umuyobozi w'akarere ka Huye afatanyije n'abo banyeshuri bo muri kaminuza baba biga n'abarangije abayobozi bandi bari mu turere batandukanye nkanungira nka nakubwira yuko buriya ibutare navuga ko ariko karere karimo zaba amashuri secondaire menshi kuko butare na Nyanza bagize amahirwe yo kugira amashuri imbere yuko ahandi bayabona so iyo mpano bafite rero barasaba kuyikoresha bereka ibyo bihugu 16 bigiye kuza kudusura uko Rwanda ruteye babereka ibyiza dufite hanyuma mbonereho no kuvuga ngo abo bafana ubwabo nibamara kwishyira hamwe bibutare nibwo ubwabo bazazana ambiance muri stade bubatswe babubakiye nshya kubera ko nubwo amavubi azaba adahari ariko ni byiza kwereka umushyitsi uko aho yageze ari mu bantu kandi bakanabereka umuco dufite birumvikana iyo amakipe akina ari abiri buri wese ahitamo ari bufane bitewe n'amarangamutima ye si bibi rwose ntabwo bibatesha agaciro ntabwo bivuga ko banza amavubi ariko umuntu wagiye kure muri stade ni byiza ko agaragaza nyina amarangamutima ye bitewe n'irimo birabera muri stade
birumvikana
twagaruka hano kuri stade amahoro rero urumvaho birarenze kuko ni umukino nyamukuru ri match d'ouverture y'amavubi na Côte d'Ivoire iri kuri stade amahoro ndagira ngo ubwize ukuri yuko guhera saa 4 imiryango izabifunguye isasa bazuzuye imiryango tuzaba twayikinze umuntu ufite inyota umuntu wumva akeneye icyo kurya kubera umuntu waje saa 4 birumvikana hano muri Afrika usibye abaganda abandi kurya mu gitondo birabagora ariko ndatekereza tariki 16 tuzabigana tuzava mu rugo twariye twanyoye ariko ufite igifu kizima nanone nagera kuri stade akongera gusonza RDB nicyo kizaba cyayizanye babateguriye icyo kunywa bazabashakira ibyo mushobora kurya kuburyo noneho umuntu wari we wese kuzinduka nibyo byiza kuri we kurusha kuza ugasanga bagukingiranye mu byo twabateguriye bizashimisha bazaba bazindutse harimo itorero ry'igihugu bazaza bari bamakoreografi bareba imyambarire ya Kinyarwanda nibarangiza bazari babana b'abasore bagendera ku masket ni ibintu basanzwe babona mu bihugu byateye imbere ndashaka kuvuga ngo muri za Amerika ariko ndagira ngo mbwire abantu bakurikiranye televiziyo y'u Rwanda yuko mu Rwanda dufite abana bashobora kuba bakora iby'abandi banyamahanga bakora ahubwo izo mpano nitwari twaragize amahirwe yo kuzigaragaza indi nyungu navuga abafana b'amavubi babona cyangwa se bagomba gufasha abakinnyi bacu kugira ngo batsinde nta yindi niko iriya match ya Cameroon ndetse na match ya Congo esheke bari bafite ku banyarwanda bakinnyi bayikuyemo ubu nitwe tubari mideni so icyo dusabwa ni ikihe turasabwa kugerageza kubaha imbaraga bagitangira kugeza barangiza niyo mpamvu rero abashyushya rugamba ijana tuzabagabanya muri stade amahoro nitumara kubagabanya mu bice bitandukanye imbyino barimo baraziga kugeza uyu munsi Huye na Rwarutabura ugahurira na Rujugiro umwe afite vuvuzera nk'esheshatu sinzi ukuntu bazazivugiriza icyarimwe ariko turaza no kubashakira ingoma dore ko n'izindi ababyinnyi bazaba bazizanye ku buryo imirishyo y'ingoma abantu bazayumva imbyino za Kinyarwanda bazazibona iza kizungu bazazibona amakomedi bazayakora kugira ngo uwo ari we wese waje tumugaragarize isura nyayo y'u Rwanda kuko muri ibi bihugu 16 abagiye baduharabika muri ibyo bihugu ni benshi niyo okazi yonyine tubonye yo kugira ngo tubagaragarize ngo abanyarwanda turi bandi igihugu cyacu kigikunda gute
hanyuma turimo gusoza muri make mu munota umwe gusa ndashaka kugira ngo umbwire wowe uburyo ubona ekipe nationale nk'umu coach n'umukino ni igikombe tugiye gukina kirimo amakipe akomeye cyane ku mugabane wa Afurika wowe kubireba mu itsinda u Rwanda ruhereyemo na yahe makipe u Rwanda rukwiye kwitondera cyane cyane
Okay, urebye amatsinda yose, amakipe yose yasa nakomeye. Ariko reka twibande ku itsinda riri mu Rwanda. Ni itsinda ririmo amakipe y'u Rwanda rwagiragije gukina narwo n'ayo makipe muri za friend match match amicale. Icyo gihe rwashoboye gukina na Maroc, rwakinye na Gabon, ariko ntabwo rwabonye amahirwe ngira ngo gukina na Cote d'Ivoire. Ni ikipe zikomeye, ni ikipe usanga zifite umuco wa sport cyane cyane muri football. Urebye muri niveau professionnel wabo bageze kure cyane, wareba n'abakinnyi benshi bakine wabo cyangwa bavuye muri ibyo bihugu bajya gukina mu mahanga bakina hanze, baba bafite umuco wa sport. Ni ikipe ziba zikomeye, ziba zifite n'amateka, cyane cyane ko n'amateka usanga ashingiye ku bakinnyi baturutse iwabo bajya hanze, ntabwo ari abakinnyi baturutse mu mahanga. Nka kuri ubona abakinnyi benshi usanga bavukira muri mu Faransa cyangwa muri Espagne bakaza gukina kandi muri Afurika, ariko usanga ari abakinnyi baturutse aho nka kuri kwa Bayature bakajya gukina hanze. Izo centre de formation, izo academy barasya zifite, urumva ko ni ibihugu biba bikomeye. Ariko hano ni mu rugo, hano ni mu rugo cyane, irabera mu Rwanda. Iyo occasion ntabwo iboneka buri munsi. Ndibaza ko urebye selection dufite hano, uburyo abakinnyi bageje kwitwara muri Sekafu ubushize by'imuntu bibiri bishize, wareba imikino ibiri bakinnyi ya Congo na Cameroon, njye birampa icyizere ko tuzagerageza kwitwara neza muri cyane. Icyangombwa ni uko abantu tugerageza kubashyigikira, tugerageza kubasapotinga cyane kugira ngo bashobore gukora gushaka za resulta performance zabo zizamuka. Nta mpungenge ifite cyane, rero ntabwo bafite kuko bashobora kuzitwara neza.
Murakoze cyane kuba mwongeye kwitabira ubutumire bwacu. Nk'uko babivuze rero, inkoko niyo ngoma kugira ngo abafana bazabe bahibereye. Murakoze cyane kuba mwitabira ubutumire, kandi turabifuriza amahirwe muri byose murimo guteganya imbere. Murakoze cyane.
Murakoze cyane.
And there you have it from the two gentlemen. Well, as already said, we have been telling you all the details, but we hope you make your way on Saturday and go after our Amavubi Star Boys. Make sure you get your vuvuzelas and your t-shirts, and let's support Team Rwanda. You're watching Rise and Shine Rwanda. Stay with us. We'll be right back after the break.
The things that make you look outside the window and sigh. The ones that make your dreamy eyes look up to the sky and smile. Forget the miles between and smile at the sky. Like it held something precious that belonged to you. Like this little secret that makes you hold everything you love. Let your passion guide you. You can be sure you will touch the sky.
Business stories making headlines today. Rwanda's horticulture industry fetched more than $6.1 million, which is equivalent to 4.7 billion Rwandan francs in the 11 months to November 2015, which is an increase from the $4.3 million realized in the same period in 2014. This was an increase of 41.3%. Rwanda is looking at horticulture, especially the flower subsector, to help spur the country's export receipts in the medium term. In fact, the National Agriculture Export Board had targeted to increase the sector's earning to $140 million worth of exports annually by 2020. The industry was earlier projected to earn Rwanda about $220 million per year by 2017, according to the roadmap by the National Agriculture Export Board. Ugandan traders have emerged as the top beneficiaries of the new tax regime that raised prices of the second-hand cars imported in Kenya. Kenyan car dealers are crying foul over the influx of cheaper vehicles, either diverted from the Ugandan board cargo or rerouted once cleared in the landlocked country. Last month, Kenya Revenue Authority officials were forced to launch a crackdown on vehicles bearing Ugandan number plates in Western Kenya following widespread complaints by local traders. Faster growth in construction, mining, and transport sectors pushed Tanzania's growth higher in the third quarter of 2015 compared to the same period a year earlier. The economy grew 6.3% year-on-year in the third quarter compared to the 5.4% in the same quarter in 2014. Albina Chua, Director General of the National Bureau of Statistics, said that during a news conference that the sectors that drew the GDP growth in the third quarter of 2015 included construction, mining, and transport. You're now up to date with today's business headlines. Sports news coming in just a moment with Moses Virikunzira.
Welcome back to Rise and Shine in Rwanda Time. Now for your sports news, I am Moses Virikunzira. Starting with local football, Gor Mahia captured Rwanda captain Jacques Tuyisenge. Amavubi skipper Jacques Tuyisenge is officially a Gor Mahia player. This after the highlighted forward, Police FC, signed a 2 years deal with the Kenyan champions on Tuesday evening. Speaking on phone to soccer25east.com from Kigali, Rwanda Police FC Secretary General CIP Maira Jean de Dieu confirmed that indeed the deal was sealed and the player is now free to join Gor Mahia after CHAN. He said it's true, Tuyisenge is now a Gor Mahia player. He will join the team after helping Rwanda national team in the CHAN tournament. And it is believed that the deal is $40,000. Now, the follow-up on FIFA corruption scandals. After two most powerful men in the world football, former FIFA president Blatter and former UEFA president Platini were banned from football activities for 8 years, FIFA sacked Secretary General Jerome Vach on Tuesday for 9 years. World football governing body FIFA has dismissed Secretary General Jerome Vach. The Frenchman, who is 55 years old, is currently suspended from all football activity for his alleged involvement in shame to profit from World Cup ticket sales. FIFA has recommended that he should be banned from football for 9 years. Vach, who was appointed in 2007, also faces bribery allegations but denies wrongdoing. The FIFA statement said, the FIFA Emergency Committee decided on 9th January 2016 to dismiss Jerome Vach from the position of FIFA Secretary General with immediate effect. Finally, in managers' merry-go-round, AS Roma sacked manager Rudy Garcia after poor run of results yesterday. Roma has sacked manager Luis Garcia after poor run of results in Serie A. Former Real manager Garcia had seen his side win just once since the beginning of November, a 2-0 win home victory against struggling Genoa. The Italian has been drawn against Real Madrid in the last 16 of Champions League, having qualified with the lowest number of points. Alberto De Rossi, who is the father of vice-captain Daniel De Rossi, took over yesterday on training session. And the CHAN, the most anticipated tournament, is going on and it's starting on Saturday, on 16th of January. Now we continue to talk in details about the group stages and the teams and their chances. Today we are talking about the Group D, comprised by Zimbabwe, Uganda, Zambia, and Mali. Here is what we compiled for you. Take a look.
And the warriors are lining up as Tapua Kapini. I'm going to go to the next one.
And joining me in studio now is Mr. Romario Abdul-Jabbar, who is the sport correspondent from Voice of Africa. Welcome to the studio, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Now we are talking about Group D. It's a group which is in turn 2016. It's comprised by Zimbabwe, Mali, Uganda, and Zambia. And this group is going to play at Lubavu. So now, Here, starting with Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is 108th in world ranking, and Zimbabwe has not been, actually in Africa, in the competition, they have not been very active. So what is your take on Zimbabwe in this group?
First, what I can say is that Zimbabwe has been consecutive in the competition, mm-hmm. Reaching the semifinals in 2014, mm-hmm. and were beaten by Libya on penalties. So yes. It's something that I find very significant that the people have really to take serious. So mm-hmm. Zimbabwe being very consecutive and, I mean, consistent, they've mm-hmm. been consistent in the competition, we have to be very careful about Zimbabwe.
Okay, so you mean you are saying that Zimbabwe might be a surprise in this group?
Not only a surprise, mm-hmm. the facts can tell.
Okay.
As I've been saying, it has been consistent in the competition. Mm-hmm. So it's something that needs credit.
All right. Now, going to Mali. Mali is a team that is all known in Africa. They have players like Seydou Keita, who played in a team like Barcelona, and he's their captain, their top scorer with 25 goals, the most capped with 102 caps. And, you know, Mali, when you talk Mali A team, the team that comes in turn. So what do you think that Mali, which is in turn, what do you think they can do?
Mali just of recent have been giving a chance to young boys through mm-hmm. the academies. They've been raising up players from the academies. And though they haven't actually been very consistent, we remember this is West African country.
Yes.
So I believe with their system, the way they organize in the federation mm-hmm. is also something that people have to think about. So people may think it's not a big team, mm-hmm. but we have to remember that that just of recent they opted to go for the youth development. So
okay.
Mali is also one of the teams that are going to show good football.
All right. Now we are talking about Uganda. The Uganda Cranes. Everyone knows the Uganda Cranes. Most recently, Rwandans know Uganda Cranes because of the defeat we had in Ethiopia recently in December. 1-0 loss to Uganda for the fourth time. Now, Uganda, we that our neighbors, we know them, they know us. So now them coming in Rwanda in this specific group, what do you think? They trust Tanzania 4-1 before they came in Rwanda. What do you think Uganda, what does Uganda stand chance in this group?
Absolutely. Remember, they recorded the 14th title
in Sekafa.
Mm-hmm. Uganda has been doing well recently mm-hmm. with the Mitchell mastering very well the East African football. Mm-hmm. Remember, they've been doing well against West African countries. Uh-huh. Recently, they had to beat Togo.
They beat Togo 3-0.
3-0 in Uganda.
Recently,
yeah,
1-0. So.
And another thing is that recently when I was talking to one of the people in the technical on the technical bench, that is Frank Vidianyao, mm-hmm. The good thing that Uganda has done is that they actually tried to go on the grassroots level mm-hmm. and try to build their team right from the grassroots level. Another thing is that their football is much more characterized by players from secondary schools. So mm-hmm. the competition for Uganda, fighting for places, they have players like Faruku Mia have been doing.
Their captain, we saw him in Sekafa, he was absolutely outstanding.
So I believe Uganda, to me, it's a force in this competition. Mm-hmm. I also give them a chance even to reach in the semifinals. Mm. Why not? They can't even win the
competition. That's absolutely. What you mean. Yeah. Uh-huh. Now going to Zambia. We know Zambia, they won 2012 cup competition. And Zambia, they have their players like Musonda, who is there. They have Karusha Buaria, who escaped the air crash. You know, you remember the time when Zambia air crash, all the 18 players and the 30 members of the crew were all died. They all died. And Karusha Buaria, who is the president of Zambia Federation, now he survived. And Zambia now as a team, what do you think Zambia stand in Africa? We saw Zambia surprising Ivory Coast in 2012. And does Zambia stand a chance in this particular CHAN competition?
Well, Zambia has been doing well too. Remember in 2012, they won the African Cup of Nations for the first time. Mm-hmm. But recently, since Hervé Renard, the French coach, left the team, mm-hmm. they haven't actually been very consistent. Mm-hmm. But also remember, it's a team that has played CAN for 16 times.
16 times, yeah.
So Zambia has its history in football. But in CHAN, I don't think there will be a big force.
So you mean CHAN doesn't stand, in CHAN, Zambia doesn't stand a lot of chances. But in 2009, they became third in the competition. Doesn't that play any role?
Yeah, it's something that I really need to talk about. But remember, when Everina left the team, they haven't actually been doing well. So it's also a little bit something
scary.
Tricky.
Yeah. All right, thank you so much to join us in the studio. As you all heard from the man himself, the sport pundit and the sport journalist, he said, this group D, no one is very clear to take over the group. So you've been watching Rise and Shine Rwanda. Stay with us. We'll be right back after the break.
The things that make you look outside the window and sigh. The ones that make your dreamy eyes look up to the sky and smile. Forget the miles between and smile at the sky. Like it held something precious that belonged to you. This little secret that makes you hold everything you love. Let your passion guide you. You can be sure you will touch the sky.
Let's take a look now at news making headlines here in Rwanda and around the world.
Dr. Vincent Biruta said Rwanda's forest recovery target of 30% of the total surface area is to be met before the 2020 deadline as the government turns focus to agroforestry. Briefing a Senatorial Standing Committee in charge of economic development and finance on the status of forestry in the country, the Minister for Natural Resources said the country's current forest coverage has so far reached 29.2% from 25.9% in 2010, with the target expected to be hit by 2018.
Rwandans who worked for the Burundian government before they returned home in 1994 have petitioned President Paul Kagame to help them get their full pension benefits. The pensioners are challenging a recent Rwandan government decision to give them back pension contributions they made in Burundi instead of paying them pension benefits as they had hoped over the years.
And in regional news, a court in Zimbabwe has thrown out a criminal insult charge brought against an MP accused of calling First Lady Grace Mugabe a fool. Justice Wanjana of the ruling ZANU-PF will now be tried on the latest charge of disorderly conduct. The case is seen as part of party wrangling over who should succeed 91-year-old President Robert Mugabe.
And in international news, President Barack Obama vigorously defended his legacy while striking an optimistic note for America's future in his final State of the Union address. He criticized the negative tone of the current presidential race, arguing the U.S. has the strongest, most durable economy in the world. The speech to Congress highlighted his accomplishments, such as health reform.
Oh, well, it's always good to talk about. I've been waiting for the State of Union address by Barack Obama because I always know that there's a lot coming up from this gentleman. One thing I have to say before, you know, we have the elections in November for the USA. I think President Obama has really set the bar so high.
Very. I do not even understand why certain stations, such as Fox News, actually say the things they do about President Obama. Because the facts are there. We know what he has done. And he has done a great job. If anything, kudos, President.
And again, he's a good speaker. Something that
is.
I think any other president would say. All right, there we have it. We take a look at what's happening in lifestyle and what's hot right now in our daily debate section, Hot Topics. And of course, with our very own Sherry Uwase. We'll be right back after the break.
Welcome back. Today in Lifestyle, we take a look at movies on the shelf at Century Cinema next week. And today the movie that we're going to talk about is The Revenant. Take a look at the trailer.
You have to fight, but you don't give up. As long as you got a breath in you.
What happened?
I'm going to kill a man who killed my son.
God giveth, God taketh away.
The Revenant, rated R, January 8th.
A little synopsis about the movie is about while exploring the uncharted wilderness in 1832, legendary frontiersman Hugh Glass, who is Leonardo DiCaprio, sustains injuries from a brutal bear attack. When his hunting team leaves him to die, basically, Glass must utilize his survival skills to find a way back home to his beloved family. Grief-stricken and fueled by vengeance, Glass treks through the wintry terrain to track down John Fitzgerald, who is Tom Hardy, the former confidant who betrayed and abandoned him. So basically, the highlight about this movie, what I love is it's Leonardo DiCaprio. When was the last time we saw him in a movie?
Well, I think I saw him
Wall
in
Street.
The Wolf of Wall Street.
Yeah, Wolf of Wall Street. And when was that?
That was last year.
2013.
No, it wasn't.
13, yes.
Yes, it wasn't that recent. It was
2014, actually.
Really?
2014, yes.
Yes.
Let's be honest.
Really?
It was, I think, 2014.
Maybe because I haven't watched it, but I just
and
felt
I
like
last
he's been
saw him
MIA.
Also take the Golden Globe home. So
yes, and for this specific movie, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
It was for this specific movie. I watched.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I followed the Golden Globes.
We can see that. So he's been doing big things. He's been. I mean, he's been. I feel like Hollywood has been very much crowded with amazing actors.
Mm-hmm.
So we haven't been noticing him as much.
Mm-hmm.
But now he's here and he's ready to take
incredible.
It. He's incredible.
He's incredible. He's incredible. I haven't watched the movie. I've seen a bit of behind the scenes on E! Entertainment. But it looks interesting. And of course, you know, his characters, they don't just have one side to them. You know, they're taken through all sorts of, you know, things in life. Mm-hmm. You know, and now look at him. He's in winter and then he's gone trekking with his group, and all of a sudden he is left for dead when he has to fight a bear.
It's actually a very nice movie. Yes.
I mean, Leonardo DiCaprio, I feel like he's going to be one time named the actors of all time. Reason being, he's been this guy that has kept the game up, just like Will Smith, just like Denzel Washington.
Oh, Denzel.
I mean, every movie I see this guy in, he's able to transform into any character you want him to play out for.
Yes.
And I think this movie, I think, him taking the Golden Globe, I think is one way step further to show you that this same guy has not yet been away from the movie scene. So we're all to see
talent is still there.
Talent is
definitely
there. And quite enough, even ladies are saying he even grows into, you know,
something
a more good looking man every day. So I don't know about that.
Ask me after.
Okay.
Yes,
for me, Leonardo DiCaprio is such a guy that, first thing first, I like his beard.
You know? Even in the movie, he has a beard.
Yeah.
Outgrew the beard.
His skills of doing something out of nothing. Fighting the impossible, you know. In this movie specifically, you know, when you are left behind, you are betrayed by your friends, those whom you trusted. And again, you need to find a way to go back and, you know, show them that though they left you behind, but we still have an opportunity to get back to where they left you. So that was the highlight for me.
All right. And now, because of time, I would like us to just move on to the cult classic. Mm. And today's classic, we have actually one of my personal favorites, Judge of the Jungle, which was a movie that was hitting up in 1997. Take a look.
We have a breaking story at the Bay Bridge.
Nobody knows who he is.
Nobody knows where he's from. But everybody knows where he's headed.
Watch out for that!
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
There's five apes out there. Which one are we taking to Vegas?
The incredible true story...
Checkmate.
The one who's playing chess.
Of ape...
Ow! Tuki! Go find George.
Tuki Tuki.
Another mimosa, Mr. Tuki Tuki?
Tuki Tuki!
The lovely Ursula.
You've been head over heels for that ape ever since you brought him here.
You're right. I love him.
And George.
Tuki Tuki!
It kidnapped?
Tuki Tuki!
Ape now!
Duh. This summer.
That's your dog?
The king of the jungle is falling in love.
George, George, George of the jungle, strong as he can be. Watch out for that tree! Watch out for that!
I give you the king of the jungle.
How many of you have watched George of the Jungle?
I've watched the cartoon.
I've watched the cartoon.
Oh, yes. You haven't
and
watched
the book?
I've watched the movie
too. A long time ago.
Yes.
But I've not the cartoon itself, the movie cartoon. Mm. But not this one is an actual, it's not animated, is it?
It's not an animated, it's a movie.
It's a movie.
Yes.
I've not watched this one.
Oh my goodness.
I've not watched this one though.
Oh my goodness. You guys, really?
Sorry guys.
I'm pretty sure she was thinking of something like Tarzan or something like that.
No, it's different. It's very similar, but it's different at the same time.
Same kind of story, but very different. But of course... George of the Jungle.
But now I'm trying to remember the song in my mind.
George of the Jungle.
Yes. So I just think for those... Actually, I just found out that there is a two, George of the Jungle 2.
Mm. Oh.
Yes, so if you haven't watched one, please, after we're done with the show, just go.
Straight to the cinema.
Straight to the...
Yeah, absolutely.
No, I'm sure you wouldn't find it in the cinema. Because it's a classic. It was in 1997. Just find it and you won't regret it.
Just talk to Sherry after this.
Yes. Okay, basically, talk to me.
Hi, Sherry.
All right, don't go. We will be right back for Hot Topics after the break. Welcome back, and it's that Hot Topics time again. You know, as always, we are always up and about, the Rise and Shine team, gathering everything that you need to know about what's happening here and abroad, from the debates that you have in your local cafe, all on Twitter, social media. We've got it all for you right here and right now. Now, this is an issue that has been affecting Kigali City. Just last year, we have been experiencing immense water shortage in Kigali. But I must say, this year there has been a slight improvement. And the key word there is slight. Now, this year, though, there has been blackouts all around Kigali. And recently, actually, to be precise, two nights ago, there was the same blackout all around Kigali. And Reg Rwanda tweeted... in Kinyarwanda, but I'm going to translate it. We have a problem with our servers, which has caused a blackout in many areas. Our technicians are doing everything possible for electricity to be back soon. Mm. Now, I just want to take it back. Last year, there was a lot of shortage.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
There's water shortages and so many power blackouts.
But this year, I think it has been a bit better. Maybe it comes once a week, and then in some areas, depending on where you are, you can have water
for
2 days.
Remember the keyword, slight.
Yeah, the keyword, slight. Now, this year, I don't know if you have noticed, but there has been a blackout going on, and it goes all around. Many places in Kigali,
like
Kimirongo, Kanombe, Nyarutarama, Kichukiro, everywhere, there's no electricity.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely.
What do you think?
And I mean, I did a story about this before, talking about how it's affecting businesses. And now these days, funny enough, the one I experienced two nights ago was at night. And it went out for at least, I think, 2 hours, if not two.
Yeah, I think it was longer than that.
Really?
I think it was longer than that.
The electricity came back like around 11 or 12. Anyway, what I can say, I mean, we're all tired of talking about this, but what I have picked from what you've just said is the fact that they went ahead to tweet, to apologize.
Right.
and to notify us that they're trying their very best mm-hmm. to make sure that we get the best service. So I would definitely recommend them for that. That was good.
Right.
But kindly do stay on your word. Actually, like, keep your word and let us get back our electricity.
Right.
All right. Well, of course, I think if one would say, if because the last time we had a blackout, I think it was around December, I think that was part of the biggest blackout in modern
I actually remember it was on a Friday.
Yes.
And everyone's phones went off.
Yes, and know? I remember I was in Musanze and I couldn't understand that people in Kigali also never had electricity.
Oh, so it also happened in Musanze?
All over the country.
It was all over the country because we talked about a couple of districts did not have electricity.
Yes, but come this new year, I think there have been some reforms within the Rwanda Energy Utility Corporation that, you know, a lot has been done to make sure that we get electricity. So it's my hope that this year, because I'm pretty sure that if they retweeted that there has been a problem with the servers, maybe there could have been problems. But of course, you know, just like we always say, this is a world that, you know, there needs to be no excuses. A lot of work needs to be done to make sure that all these small mistakes that we are kind of seeing
should
within the energy should be removed out. And, you know, a lot of professionalism showed out within the work, because I'm pretty sure we don't want to see a country that is in dark for hours. So my hope goes out that this year, part of what we want to see, that some people that are really working hard are within the electricity part of it. And of course, we need more water. I can't stop complaining.
Basically, it is something that has been, you know, a big issue, a big talk. Many people have been talking about it. On my side is, I would challenge LEG authorities that in the case of this problem, do they have a backup? Do they have anything that would back up people's businesses? Because if electricity goes out for 5 hours, I mean, someone who is not in the business where he needs electricity 24/7, how much money will he use on fuel? Mm-hmm. For a generator.
Actually, how much things are going to be spoiled just because
there are so many things in
the
fridges,
like
many different people,
and
people have servers also they use in their businesses. And there's so many businesses that requires electricity. So, like now we're on TV. Assume we don't have a backup we are not short. We are not notified about the power to go out, and the TV goes out. It's a national TV. What would you do? It's a problem. And you know, they should think about in case the power goes out, do you have a backup of at least 24 hours?
Yes.
If that backup is, those generators are there for 24 hours, why they are maintaining their systems, that could help. I think they should think about what to do, because Rwandans, we are in a modern age, we need electricity 24/7.
Yes, yes. This is the 21st century, honestly. This is the digital era, you know. You can't have an excuse not to have water, first of all, and not to have electricity.
Basic essentials.
Yes. But I want to commend Reg, what they've done, at least they had that responsibility to apologize and say this is what was going on.
Yes, public
and they have been improving.
Better.
Yeah, this year I can see some improvement.
Definitely.
So we hope that it's going to go on for quite some time.
It gets better. We can't wait to see.
Yes,
all right.
Exactly. Yeah. All right, that is all the hot topics we have for you. Do not go away. We'll be right back after the break.
Don't forget, we love to hear your thoughts, comments, and feedback on what we're talking about here on Rise and Shine Rwanda. Tweet us at Rise and Shine RW. Like us on Facebook and send us your ideas for programs. Check out our Rise and Shine Rwanda YouTube page where you can catch all the shows and reports we do. Finally, find us on Instagram, Rise and Shine RW. We love to see your pictures. Or check out our Rise and Shine Rwanda website, www.riseandshinerwanda.com. Well, that is all the time we have for you today. We do love to hear your feedback, so keep sending them in. You have been watching Rise and Shine Rwanda with me, Yvette Chimbusho.
And me, Ivan Magwene. We'll be at same time, same place tomorrow. Do join us then. But for now, from the both of us and the rest of the Rise and Shine team, have a very good day. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.